Hey there, how's it going? What is up, everybody? Irish Orangutan is back to pass along the updates and info to make the most of your Madden team. Enjoy! Today we are back to talk about the best team no money can buy in Madden 20 Ultimate Team. Very excited about the upgrades that we have been able to make. Like you all know, with the no money spent team, it is a little bit incremental from time to time, but we did make some big changes, and players that we did pick up were a little bit expensive, but we've put the X factors on them and made them as best as they could be. And now players that were standout players are now just kind of backups, and that's actually making my team significantly better. So now the number one receiver is going down to the number two receiver. The best left tackle that I could potentially have without breaking the bank is now moving back to backup tackle, and now just playing my main tackle position when I move Joe Thomas out to tight end. So just some huge advances that I've been able to make, and very excited about sharing those all with you. And we'll actually get things kicked off with the left tackle position, because I don't think I actually had Trent Williams the last time that I spoke with y'all either. He is or was a huge upgrade over what I did have. I had Anthony Munoz, not powered up because I was planning on upgrading as soon as we got to Trent Williams. We got him, and shortly then after that, Joe Thomas started to drop significantly in what he was going for because of the house rules event that allowed those series reduxes to be popping out of packs. Played with him, finished up house rules with him pretty much. Helped me get through my last 20 wins, I believe, is all I needed to get, because they doubled up on the second part of this house rules. He's been someone that I've put nasty streak on, and it really has changed my offense. Was passing the ball significantly more with a 3rd and 20, and just trying to learn how to pass a little bit better over the past few weeks. But now that I feel as if I've gotten some pass plays to kind of complement my running game, I have went back to running the ball to a high percentage that way. Was actually closer to 70, maybe 75% passing. Now I'm closer to the 60% running like I was doing earlier in the year, and now I'm a lot more comfortable with what I did have in my offense, especially with a nasty streak offensive lineman helping me out. I did have Gene Upshaw, who I believe can also get the nasty streak, but he cannot be subbed out in the same way. I have been using him with jet sweeps and also just stretches to the outside. Excuse me, going back to Joe Thomas, and that's really where I've been able to accentuate like what he's been able to do, and just made him the best player that I could be, and made my offense the best that it could be. Going along with some of those jet sweeps, the fastest man in football did get an upgrade, and I did go out and nab him on my team. He does have 97 speed, being powered up, and also having sprinter on him as well. With Joe Thomas, sorry, side note, I was not going to power him up, and after playing with him and getting through a few games and also now some weekend league games, I did actually power him up after finishing up playing yesterday. But with Tyreek Hill, he's been able to really change my offense with what I've been able to burn over top. With Tyler Lockett, he was doing a tremendous job. He was pretty much in the same role that Hill was, but he just does not have that top-end speed. He's a better route runner, except for the deep route running. I do have to say, looking again at this Tyreek Hill card, he just cannot catch as well. His route running really is not that shabby, but with Hill's card next year, his spectacular catch, I do believe, will go up, because he has been able to pull off some crazy things this year while he has been playing. Another wide receiver upgrade that I am excited about is this Andre Reed. Recording this before Legends do come out, but excited to actually have him probably as my third wide receiver and move Lockett down once again. For Torrey Holt, do have him maxed out now that we have reached the top Mutt level, and with 94 speed and just that route running that's absolutely tremendous, he's a perfect slot wide receiver. Andre Reed is actually going to be a tremendous slot wide receiver to complement him, but I'm actually going to be able to get Andre Reed up to 95 speed as of today. His stock card is going to be 91, get him up to 92 with the power up with just this path,
And then from there, have the Redskins and then the times two sprinter chem, which will get him up to that 95 speed. So he'll be able to do some things that Lockett is not able to do. Lockett is definitely my second best wide receiver with the ball in his hands. But as soon as Antoine Randle-L gets an upgrade, he'll definitely be better in that way. And Lockett will then start to move down to my fourth or fifth wide receiver. And at that point, I really need to have Washington players there to fill out the 25 players so I can get that speed boost as I have more specialty players playing in those positions, especially on defense. At running back, a lot is the same. Adrian Peterson is just there for depth purposes. He does not ever reach the field. If I do need a halfback, and for some reason both of these players are tired, which I do not believe has happened yet, Christian Okoye would come in the game. I actually do bring in Okoye before I bring in Barkley frequently. Schlesinger was going to be my third tight end and play a lot in that role, but now that I've gotten Joe Thomas, he's become a lot less valuable. If I would decide to put Schlesinger in place of a Kittle and move Kittle out to wide receiver, that could be a tremendous option. Kittle is someone who I have wanted to upgrade since his limited card has came out, but for 600,000 coins, he's not that much of an upgrade over Delanie Walker. Going to be a little bit better of a pass catcher, but a little bit drop down in the run blocking game. So, not someone that I'm probably going to get. These two offensive linemen who cost a little bit more probably are a more significant fit for my offense than this Kittle. Linemen don't always play the best, but if they are near maxed out, like this Dan Dierdorf with the 92 pass block power and pass block finesse, and also you have Joe Thomas, who, I mean, Dierdorf also has tremendous run blocking ability, but this Joe has 92 pass block power and 95 pass block finesse. I'm not going to need to upgrade either of those positions for a very long time. At the tight end position, there might be a few other players that do come along that could match what Kittle can do. It is going to be very hard to find another good run blocker that's going to be able to pass catch like him, but just something to contemplate when looking at your run blockers in front of you. Another upgrade that I did decide to make that probably could have waited at least until I got done passing the ball a little bit more than I was picking up this Lamar Jackson. He is a tremendous fit with how much I am running the ball and just how scary he can really be with what he brings to the table with that 93 speed. The one knock on him is his slower release compared to Aaron Rodgers. Aaron Rodgers is absolutely perfect without putting any abilities on him, but if you put abilities on other quarterbacks, Steve Young, Andrew Luck, Lamar Jackson, players like that, they will be better options for you than this Aaron Rodgers, unless you are strictly looking for that release. But with the one play beaters and other passing plays that I have gotten, I've actually went away from having that slot route master as well, or just having that player that has slot route technician, excuse me, that has ability to run those extra four routes. And I've really been able to run a lot of things stock, and just with his ability to release the ball quickly, he's been able to win a lot for me. So just something to think about when thinking about your quarterbacks and how much speed you really do need with him. That Aaron Rodgers actually does have legit speed with 79 with his sprinter added to him also. That is what we have for the offense. On defense, we have made a few more upgrades. We do always have the issue where we try to come over here and players do not pop up. Something that's been able to help me out, most of the time I do this off screen and edit it out. But if you click on that player and then go back more times than not, all the players will be there. So if you want to take a picture or take a screenshot, excuse me, that is something that could potentially help you out. I was talking about speed quite a bit with all the players on offense. As you can see in the upper portion of my screen, I'm only 230 series trophies away from getting that John Madden boost that actually will get me the speed as well. Do just have offense and defensive chem, or excuse me, offensive passing and rushing chems to help out in that way. Was having more issues with my offense at the beginning of the year. Now that's kind of changed, but just going out and spending a little bit more on defense, so feels as if the boost on offense still fit more or less. As you can see, I have pretty pretty much too many sprinters to fill out my team, but everyone is getting that 2+ boost. I was putting on offensive linemen who didn't necessarily need it to make sure I would get to that 30 level when I was just getting there. So just something to think about. Don't overspend there. And as we get closer to the end of the year, I do believe there will be other chems that will potentially be better than sprinter that don't necessarily weigh other attributes around speed that would be significant. And probably a lot of the players that you will have will be able to get to 101 speed, but if they max it at 99, then you probably want to go elsewhere and try to max out agility and acceleration. Again, have those 25 Washington Redskins players to help me out with speed, as you can start to see on defense and offense. That does help me significantly with skill positions. For zone run and go deep, have 25 and 25. Deep accuracy and deep route running aren't as significant to me as getting the one carry and one run blocking, and the other way around. I think one throw power and one spectacular catch is more important than getting elusiveness or run block finesse, is why I have those at 25 and 25 and not 20 and 30 or something in that regard. And on defense, have not really decided to go in one way and don't necessarily have enough players playing in position. Well, we'll get into that in a second, but to potentially have them maxed out in two different ways and have it an issue passing or running, I guess, in a significant way to push that one way or the other. Redskins passing D do have a significant amount of defensive backs playing for Washington. Deion Sanders, actually, if we click on that, they'll pull him up. That's actually pretty much every position because it's highlighted then in the background as well. But Champ Bailey, Quentin Dunbar, Deron Payne, technically, Jonathan Allen, Deion Sanders, I mean, Ioannidis, but they don't reach the field. And then Ken Houston as well. Trey Apke, but he's not going to be on the field if I can help it very often. So have these plus two for man coverage, zone coverage, finesse, press, catch, and power move. Huge helps for all of those things, and can't really go wrong with that. I have actually maxed out what I could potentially do with adding this Redskins balanced O as a catching juke move run and play action, I believe. Throw on the run, I think, was the third one. That is just helping all my players with being able to catch one, is why I did go that way. Helps out the cornerbacks, helps out the offense. So those are what I'm kind of doing for chems to kind of help you out. On offense, I had Clint Portis, Joe Thomas, as I talked about extensively, and Tyreek Hill as my three superstars. Over here, I was going against a lot more passers, so I worked with Lawrence Taylor and Jadeveon Clowney, and then had Pat Tillman, of course, as that enforcer player behind it all. But Jadeveon Clowney was one of those big upgrades that I did make this past week. He actually is using my 92 power up pass at this point, as you can kind of see why once looking at the card. That 88 speed at an outside linebacker slash defensive end position is absolutely scary when you think about what he brings with it. 89 block shed at 92 power move. Honestly think this is top three player to pick with that 92 power up pass. Number one is probably Deion Sanders. I would say number two, Tyreek Hill, but his price is not nearly as high as some of these other players. Clowney's price is actually getting significantly lower as well. I am playing him out of position, and I am playing him out of position while actually using the out of position option with him. I will have a video going over this and a little bit more of what I'm using some of these other things for, but this has allowed me to play him at left outside linebacker, keep all of his chems. Again, he only has that one balanced D. Really could start looking at maxing out the defensive chems a little bit more, but haven't found a really good reason to do so if I'm not going to stick with it. Trading it really isn't that expensive, but there just really are better things you can do with it than spending it unwisely when you don't need those chems. So Clowney was one of those big upgrades. Donald was actually the player that I was planning on using and keeping my 92 power-up pass on. Actually planning on using that in 10 days when I reach my goal for dailies, or not my goal, but EA's goals of dailies. I think is 125 days, you get a 91 to 92 power-up pass. So if you've been doing everything diligently, that should be coming up for you very, very soon. This Aaron Donald is a tremendous defensive tackle. He is someone that I'm doing the same thing as I did with Clowney, just playing him out of position. His speed is a little bit wanting when you do not have his full card there, and his overall is a little bit lower as well. Still am at that 92 overall, 93 on offense. Actually dropped to a 91 overall on defense since this actually took a tick down. Sold my Von Miller card, so that was pretty solid gain for me as well to get a better player technically for free with my power up pass. I had to obviously power him up to that point, but then getting rid of Von Miller has helped me keep 3 million coins in my bank account or in my whatever account while going through this all. So Aaron Donald is a tremendous fit at the defensive line position. I really would try to fit him in at tackle with some of the other better options that you can play at the outside. Taylor is another better option with his speed coming off the edge. As far as I'm concerned, with Donald coming in with that edge threat, it is something to kind of consider, but I would really go with a Taylor and a Clowney with that edge threat, with that extra speed, trying to run down Russell Wilson, Vic, and all the other players that you may be going against in head-to-head. Next up, we have Quentin Dunbar, somebody who I added late, probably right after I had recorded the other video, but thankfully he came out right as weekend league rewards were coming out, so he actually was very inexpensive on the market, and I was able to get him picked up very, very quickly. Not a lot to say about him. Tremendous press man corner. Used to play wide receiver, so can kind of man up and play them very well. Ray Lewis, without his abilities, I would not necessarily play significant time in the passing game. He actually has been a liability in a couple of different situations. Shazier is significantly better with his different type of athleticism and also his ability to snag the ball as well. So just something to consider there. Have been able to kind of fill out the roster again with some of these backups that are starting to get a little bit better and actually could potentially play, at least with their athleticism in a couple of spots. But that is what we have for now. Very excited about what we've been able to put together and what we're going to continue to put together. But I hope your team is continuing to build like mine. And hopefully we'll be able to play sometime very soon. And hopefully I'll get over using Nasty Streak with Joe Thomas here pretty quick, so y'all don't have to deal with that. I wish y'all the best and take care.
Thanks for checking out the Irish Rantaine channel. Make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button to get all the Madden updates and info you need to put together a team better than your friends and win more head-to-head games online. Until next time, much love.